What is happening? What is happening? Oh, let me just move this up here. There we go. Alright. We're getting ready to do the Jenna challenge. Here, I wanted to show you guys something nice. This is a diff emulator, so maybe I won't glitch out. So there's this little thing called update. So what you can do is you can actually start a new game and save it, and then later on use the password to update the game. So without further ado, let's get started. I really don't like the name Felix, because it keeps reminding me of that damn cat from, like, the 50s. You know what? I'm gonna call in. Call him one of my favorite video game characters of all time. Dart. No. Wait, his name was Isaac. I think. Ages ago. Or so the stories tell, the power of alchemy ruled over the world of Wayar. Alchemy wrought the base elements of humanity into thriving civilizations like lead into gold. But in time, man's dreams gave birth to untold strife. Dreams of endless riches, of eternal life, of dominion over all that lived. Dreams of conquest and of war. These dreams would have torn the world apart if not for a few brave and wise men who sealed away the power of alchemy deep in the Mount Aleph's Sol Sanctum. Prologue from Book 1. The town of Vell guarded the secret for many years until Isaac and Jenna, whose parents died in a storm 3 years before, disturbed the sanctum. But did they die? I don't know. There's a Mary and Mars clan following the sanctum with them, traveled Jenna's brother Dart, got lost in that same tragic storm. Zetros and Minardi stole the elemental stars, the keys to breaking the seal on the power of alchemy, and kidnapped Jenna and the Scarlet Raiden. Yeah, we went through all this. If these four jewels were used on to fire the elemental lighthouses, the seal on alchemy would be broken. Isaac and Garrett set out to stop Satoros, rescue their friends, and return the elemental stars to their home in Sol Sanctum. They banded together with a young wind of death named Ivan and pursued Satoros and Minardi to Imna, a winter locked down near Mercury Lighthouse. Winter locked town. My bad. There they met the guardian of the lighthouse, a water adept named Mia. With her, they pursued Satoros to the airy high atop Mercury Lighthouse. Isaac was too late to stop Satoros from lighting the beacon and escaping. Again, Isaac chased him across Angara to the shores of the Kerrigal Sea. A passage on a troubled ship, Isaac crossed the Kerrigal to Telby, where he spoke with Telby's leader. Strange man named Bobby. Bobby entered Isaac in the Colosso as a test of his powers. Isaac's synergy won Colosso and earned him Bobby's trust. Actually, it was physical attacks. Thank you. Bobby revealed a great secret to Isaac. Thanks to a mystic drought from the lost land of Lemuria, Bobby lived for 150 years. He offered to help Isaac, who then had the Gondwan. Town of Lalivero, Isaac learned that Satoros and Minardi had kidnapped a young girl named Sheba. whom they needed within the lighthouse. You'd think that they would have had a little bit more dialogue with the Sheba situation, but they didn't. Isaac fought and defeated them atop the lighthouse, but it was too late. The beacon had been lit. A great cataclysm followed. Sheba fell into the sea. Dart jumped in to save her, but both were lost in the rolling waves. Jenna left the lighthouse to find them, but to no avail. Isaac went to Lothavero, where Bobby asked him to find Lemuria and the remaining lighthouse. He gave Isaac and Lemurian ship to make the journey from the lost land. This chapter of our story begins with Jenna just before the beacon on the Venus lighthouse is lit. So, anyways. Yeah, we know. I like how they kept that music from the first one. It seems like there's a lot more dialogue in this version of the game, though. Sucks. Oh, well, hi, Alex. What's going on? Slipping between rifts, bro. What if that electricity just decided to come back on, like, right now? Kratom would be so screwed. And I'm about to go off. Jeez, Jenna, let it go. Women. Am I right? No, I'm just kidding. Nope. And gain ultimate power. No, I'm just kidding. Alright, let's save it. I'm just gonna save all this one. I really don't need that herb. There they are, get them. This is hilarious. Let's get out of here. Thank you. You'd probably just wreck anybody with that fume attack. It's like my favorite synergy move. Do you see a clue? Oh, there it is. The handy-dandy notebook. Thank you. Look at that, Kraden. You're obviously dead. Let's go check on. Yes. Wow, it's been forever. Alright, well anyways, we're going to go ahead for now, and we're going to stop part one, or episode one, for now, and we'll continue next time. Hang on, I have 200 coins, see what we can get. No. Sorry about that. I'm really tired. Anyways. Sorry, just going through this part is kind of boring whenever, you know. We're almost there. Yeah! Go down! I swear to Zeus. Anyway, sorry, I'm back. Oh my god, no. Damn. Oh. Yes, left. Alright, let's see if we can get our first Jenna over here. Alright, anyways, that's the end of the Jenna challenge. I mean, the first episode of the Jenna challenge. There's no escape. That's cool. And, I'm just gonna call it a day after this fight here. Alright. I'm gonna save, actually, heal. Alright, we're gonna save it. And, we'll see you on the next episode. Have a good day.